Calgary. My name is John Paul Fox, and I'm here to do an underwater reading from my latest book called The Golden City. We've laminated part of the book so that it can be read underwater. We'll be using a full-face mask and underwater communications to record the event, and then we'll put it up on YouTube for the world to see. So, no matter where you are in the world, welcome to the Golden City. I am John 12 Fox.
I realize that it's a surprise to see my face on your monitor screen. Some of you might be frantically pushing the delete key or wondering if you should unplug your computer. The first thing I need to explain is that your computer hasn't been harmed and none of your data has been lost. My message to you is a one-time event. When I finish speaking, this video will end and will never appear without your permission. You can erase it or play it again by searching on your hard disk for a file called Revelation. Right now, I'm in the United States in California where something terrible has happened. 14 children have disappeared. Gabriel held up a photograph of one of the kidnapped children, including a little boy named Roberto Cabral. The people listening to this message have different nationalities and speak different languages, but all of you can understand how the loss of a child evokes powerful emotions. The parents living in California are frightened. They're worried that they cannot protect their children. Towards the end of this message, I'm going to share some news about the lost children. But first, I need to explain why all this happened. The disappearances were not some random event caused by a madman. The children were kidnapped because of an elaborate plan created by my brother Michael Corrigan, who is currently the head of the Evergreen Foundation. The foundation is the public face of a group called the Brethren. A secret overview might be asking, is the Brethren a left-wing or a right-wing group? What? These kinds of questions are not misguided, just irrelevant. Ideology is dying in our new age. Political slogans have become code words for different cultural and economic groups. In most countries, left-wing and right-wing governments share the same goal, to strengthen the technology that watches our lives. This all-pervasive system of electronic surveillance is called the vast machine. Some of you have already become aware of this new system. One morning you wake up, look around, and realize that surveillance cameras are everywhere. It feels like you've stepped into a massive electronic prison. But the cameras are only a small part of the vast machine. Every major government in the world is reading your email messages and listening to your phone calls with scanning programs that react to certain words and phrases. Security agencies and corporations monitor your bank and credit card event activity. Your mobile phones and your car generate data about your location and activities. We can usually see the cameras, but the rest of our prison is invisible. Sophisticated software programs acquire information from your purchases, your work activity, and your medical files to create a shadow image of your life. Separate databases are being combined into a total information system, and this data will be saved forever. Many people will gladly trade their personal privacy for small improvements in their lives. I have done nothing wrong, proclaims the honest citizen. So why should I be worried? We are being watched, but who is in charge of the watching? Although some of us freely offer up our private lives to the vast machine, we have no knowledge of how the information is being used, and who is using it. Criminals can duplicate our identities, corporations can manipulate our spending behavior, governments can manufacture and crush dissent. We are seen, but they are faceless. We are asked to live in a transparent house while the forces of power are concealed. In order to justify these changes, the brethren have used the politics of fear. Kings and dictators have always used this as their political philosophy. In addition, there are very few leaders that challenge the public to be brave and take responsibility for their lives. The political credo of our time sounds like an all-powerful parent talking to a child. Sit down and don't ask questions. We'll take care of everything. Michael Corrigan has created a crisis here in California. He's used the politics of fear to gain support for something called the Guardian Angel System. In this system, every child under the age of 13 will have a radio chip implanted beneath their skin. Some of you might think this is an impossible fantasy, but the technology is fairly simple. In China, the authorities are insisting that everyone carry a special ID card. The card can be detected by sensors that allow the vast machine to track your movements. The infrastructure is already in place for a world where our individual self becomes just another object like an automobile or a television set. In this system, we become a mobile ID chip, moving through an environment of other chips that link and communicate with each other. Our individual actions are simply more data for the machine. Privacy is the ability to control access to information about oneself. It's easy to see that this invisible, all-pervasive system will destroy any sort of privacy. We'll lose the power to protect ourselves from the scrutiny of unknown groups or individuals. And some of you may ask, is there any value to privacy? All new ideas are dependent on some kind of mental privacy, the potential for peace and reflection. The vast machine provides information about us and gives the authorities a wide variety of ways to manipulate our thoughts with a subtle power. Everything we hear and see can be shaped to create certain prejudices. Free will, that is, our ability to make real choices about significant issues, becomes an illusion. Gradually, we are surrounded by targeted messages that destroy the others and corrupt institutions. If you have a positive view of humanity, then you can see how freedom allows new ideas and technical innovation. Religious and political dictatorships lumber down the road like an old truck spitting out foul exhaust. The entire country cannot turn in a new direction when the scenery begins to change. The vast machine carries us towards a world where free thought and the expression of these thoughts becomes difficult, and sometimes impossible. And the politics of fear gives our leaders the justification for more control. Gabriel picked up the photograph, and sometimes the threat is exaggerated or even false. Here in California, the Evergreen Foundation made 14 children disappear, but they are alive and safe, and their story will validate my message. Of course, there are real terrorists, and we should defend ourselves against their attacks. But the anthrax incident in Tokyo, the bombings in Paris, and the poison food in Australia are events deliberately created to establish a permanent system of control. Look behind the curtain and ask yourself, who really benefits from these changes? Some of us have had enough of fear and manipulation. In the next few days, we will appear in the chambers of power and in the streets. Join us, stand with us. Who speaks for freedom? It's your choice. So this has been part of a book, a new book called The Golden City by myself, John Twelvehut. I'd like to thank you for watching and listening. And on September 10th, I invite you to go to your nearest bookstore and pick it up and read it. If you'd like to check out more, you can look at www.iamjohn12vehut.com. Thank you and good night. Okay, we're done.